Hey guys, Brennan here with Brennan's Tech Byte. I'm back and in full force for the summer. I'll be doing some more app reviews, product reviews, and also I'll be posting some more videos on the Flycam Nano. But today I'll be doing one of my most requested video, which is some more Mac tips. So let's get started. All right, so let's start off in the trash, which is always a great place to start off in. Let's say you delete a file or folder, but you actually don't want to delete it and you want to put it back in its original location. All you have to do is right-click that file or folder, and then select Put Back, and then it will put back that file into its original location. If you want to monitor your Mac's performance, just go to a pre-installed app called Activity Monitor, and then this app will show you your CPU performance, system memory, disk activity, disk usage, and your network information. Up here, it will also show you all the different processes that are going on your Mac. And another way to monitor your Mac is if you go down to the dock icon of the Activity Monitor, and if you right-click it, you can go to dock icon, and then you can change it to show your memory usage. So that means whenever you run an application, this green pie slice will show you how much free memory you have left, and the pie slices will change as you run different applications on your Mac. Another thing you can do is right-click this icon, and then go to Monitors, and then you can float your CPU usage onto your Mac screen, so you can constantly monitor it right here. And then again, as you run different applications, your CPU usage will change. So this is just an overall great way to monitor all the processes of your Mac. I'm sure you get a lot of spam emails from companies like Target, Best Buy, Macy's, and everyone else, and it just completely clutters your inbox. But on almost all of these emails from all of these companies, if you scroll down to the bottom of this email, it will give you an option such as deactivate or unsubscribe. And then if you click it, it will unsubscribe you from their mailing list and you won't get any more emails from them. Dashboard is a great place to view all of your widgets, but sometimes the widgets that Apple provides aren't too useful. To make your own custom widget, go to Safari and then select Open in Dashboard from the menu. And then highlight the area of the screen that you want to be your widget. Now just finalize it and you have your own custom widget in Dashboard. Spotify is awesome because you can listen to almost any song for free, but you will get those occasional audio ads every few songs. But I found if you want to skip those ads, all you have to do is select a new song before your current song ends, and you'll never have to hear another ad in Spotify. Those pesky updates you get on the top right-hand corner of your Mac screen can be annoying sometimes. To get rid of them, you can swipe right with your mouse or trackpad. But if you want to turn them off for the day, just launch the notifications, swipe up, and then select Turn Off. I have a few favorite features in iTunes that I thought I would share with you. First, you're able to watch and download full HD clips and trailers of some of the upcoming movies in the movie section of the iTunes Music Store. Another thing I like about iTunes is you can make a wish list by clicking on the down arrow of any song, music video, movie, or app, and then you can view all your wish list items in one spot, and then you can decide what you want to purchase later or now. And my favorite feature of iTunes is you can redeem an iTunes gift card by simply holding the code in front of your iSight camera. Your camera will scan it and then it will automatically redeem it. You no longer have to type in that long code, which is really cool. I'm sure you all know you can back up your Mac's hard drive with Time Machine and an external hard drive, but you can also back up all your other external hard drives onto your Time Machine by selecting Options and then selecting those disks. So this way, every single hard drive you own will be backed up to your Time Machine. Thank you guys for watching. Stay tuned for the rest of my videos for this summer. Subscribe right down below so you can be notified when they are up. And I'll see you all next time. Take care.